Hello and welcome to this week's episode of Goa Ahead. Land and planning have always been most controversial and matters of public agitation in Goa. One of the major components of planning is outline development plans for cities and townships. This new government has suddenly taken a decision to suspend proposed and draft outline development plans, citing discrepancies by the same government in the previous term. What does this indicate? What are its implications and what is a ground reality? I have four eminent panelists with me in studio. Joining me, President of CREDAI, Nilesh Salkar. Nilesh Bab, welcome. Next, I am joined by architect and spokesperson of the Congress Party, Tulio D'Souza. Tulio Bab, welcome. Joining me online is former President of CREDAI and BJP leader Desh Prabhudesai. Desh Bab, welcome. And I am joined by Aam Aadmi Party leader and lawyer Amit Palekar. Amit, welcome. Nilesh, I'll start with you. How are you looking at this decision? Because government is saying two things very clearly. Number one, grave discrepancies for which an emergency clause has been used. Number two, suspension of draft and proposed ODPs. So from a business standpoint, industry standpoint, how are you looking at this decision?
To begin with, we are very happy with the intent and the urgency shown by the government and the town and country planning minister. It was really a revolutionary step by him to make the announcements that he made. As far as the outline development plans are concerned, they are the lifeline of our industry. And as such, their suspension could lead to a disruption in day-to-day activities of our members. Having said that, and given the intent of the government, we are happy to go with him for a period of 2 months. If we can resolve all the problems in 2 months, it means that we start again on a clean slate and gain the confidence of all the public as well as the bureaucracy, the NGOs, and then we should not have any reason for worry.
But Nilesh, when you speak about problems, what kind of problems are we talking about, or what kind of discrepancies are we talking about? Nilesh.
See, discrepancies in the sense, the whole planning exercise that was undertaken was very haphazard. Like, although they have followed all the points of the law, that is notifications, objections, scrutiny of those objections and re-notifying the whole thing. So the legal process has been ticked. So all we have tick marks on all the right. What is really lacking over here is the planning point of view in all these ODPs. So you will find that there is a C1 zone next to a S4 zone, or something has been given without any reasoning to say so. So that is the whole problem. So that is what the discrepancy is. That is the discrepancy that the minister is probably referring to.
Tulio Bab, how are you looking at this? Because it's a very drastic step. The government is saying that it's a daring step, courageous step to introduce some corrections. How is your party looking at it, and as a professional also?
See, first of all, let me tell you, as a professional, I welcome the Honorable Minister's move to get the outline development plans re-looked at. Because his own government, which undertook this exercise of hurriedly notifying these all ODPs in the past 1.5 to 2 years, was done in a mighty hurry, as I said. And secondly, although the due steps as mandated by the law were followed, but in spirit, everybody knew that there was something amiss while formulating these ODPs.
What was amiss?
What was amiss is exactly the people's participation in this ODP. You see, the people, as my colleague Nilesh has said, people are the biggest stakeholders of this ODP. And today, when we see that the people are the biggest stakeholders of the ODP, one has a look at the social media or all the print and electronic media, the people have generally welcomed this move. Now, how far this move will result in an ODP being redrawn, redrafted, or redone in a manner that it will fulfill the aspirations of the people, we will have to wait and watch.
Amit, how are you looking at this step? Because government is making it perfectly clear that we are doing this for the sake of transparency.
Look at this part of it. It is a very populist kind of a decision, maybe political decision as I look at it. If you look at the 14 years of the current government, we have not been able to get our regional plan in place. We know for sure why ODPs have been created in North Goa, in various parts of Goa. Of course, to accommodate MLAs. CREDAI has been on record to say 8% of their cost goes into corruption. So, and then we have a backdoor entry of 16B notification, which is of course challenged before the High Court, but that is being defended by the court, by the government. Now, if you look at it, illegal conversions by way of backdoor has been has been happening. So I don't know how this is going to benefit Goans. The intentions, if they are correct, and if they are given minister has been talking about that he wants to correct it. Of course, it required corrections, and whole of Goa knows about it. But we all know we have no trust in this government, and we have seen that in the last 14 years of governance, that all these regional plan or ODPs have been a fertile ground for corruption. So it should benefit Goans if it has to benefit Goans. But as Sarkar said, and Mr. Tulio also said, both are in the field, and I am also a lawyer for a lot of real estate builders. ODPs have only benefited non-Goan builders because it came with price tag. And you, as you say, next to two S4 zone properties or S1 zone properties, you have a commercial building coming up. Places like Para were converted into different zones, which would not fit the entire genetics of the village. So if the intentions are right, if the minister believes that all this needs to be corrected, then let's wait and see. But with the kind of history that we know of the government, it looks like a ploy to probably get more benefits and kickbacks. And that is what has been happening over the years as far as Goa is concerned. And when it comes to regional plan, otherwise, why would we not have regional plan in place? We are using a regional plan which has been in abeyance by way of a backdoor entry. And I think if Goa's people's interests are at forefront, then I think immediate action would be required, because I think I'm sure the real estate industry would be suffering due to this suspension, because they might have put plans in place. What has been stated is that whatever constructions that have begun will be allowed, but the constructions which have not begun may not be allowed. And in that case, what happens to those builders who have put in all the other things in place and spent money?
Okay, very, very interesting part. Because there are, you raised many points, Amit, and we'll go one by one into those details. But before I go there, Deshbab, 2 points. Number one, as a stakeholder, how are you looking at this decision? As a party man, this is a weird thing. Your own government is saying that the outline development plans prepared by your own government has huge discrepancies.
What has happened is that advocate Amit Palekar and Tulio said, they had apprehension as opposition party, they had apprehension about this government, that there was something wrong with this ODP. And it is a political wheel if somebody has got. And that is what our ECB minister has shown with the help of our chief minister, that we can do this. And I think with this, we should trust, or everybody should trust this move, because what has happened is down the line, what we have said is that as a real estate builder, the housing industry, one of the members, what we have seen is that every now and then there is some chaos here and there. After the ODP settled down, then again the ODP is reviewed. So this time he has taken a bold step, is that let's come together, spend some time, 1 or 2 months, and get it right. And you could know that what exactly he has done is he's put technical people on that. With, of course, some of the members are stakeholders like our CREDAI or CII and different other institutions. But moreover, it will be headed by a technical person who will look into this aspect if at all there are some discrepancies. And if it is set right within 2 months, I think we can come up clean on these ODPs.
Amit raised some very pertinent issues. What happens when it comes to planning and land? Every time when it comes to planning and land, there are issues, there are doubts, there are allegations of corruption. As you mentioned, there are clear examples of haphazard planning. Nilesh Bab, what happens? Because we have seen this from probably last 1.5 decade from the regional plan 2011, from that agitation till now, we haven't been able to settle our planning problem. What's wrong?
See, basically, it starts with the type of people that are employed with the planning and development authorities. With the exception of the member secretary, who is a qualified planner, most of the other staff do not really qualify as planners. As a result, they are more involved in only scrutiny of files which are submitted to the authority for approvals. As the name suggests, Planning and Development Authority, the authority is required to take a planning of a proper place. If that is itself not present in that expertise itself is not planning with is available with the authority, how do you expect that you will see results on the ground? It is not going to happen. Planning, the draft outline plan, ODP, need not necessarily be opened every 10 years. Planning is a dynamic process. Why not do it on a year-to-year basis? Why not do it on a quarterly basis? What is wrong? As an owner, I feel that my property needs to be monetized, then the outline development plan should provide me with enough potential so that I can monetize my land holding. Okay, this is not to say that I go on a rampant building exercise. There are other ways of monetizing your property, which is followed all over the world. For example, in most of the older cities of Europe, they did not allow building in the city centers. Instead, the city centers were pedestrianized. As a result, the towns over there still retain their ethnic character.
I also believe that the political class of the state has always looked at the issue of land and planning as a cash cow. From the perspective of planning. Because we have seen PDS getting created to satisfy somebody's political ambitions also.
That is the case all over the world, and I don't think we can ever come out of this. We will have to live with this fact. And this is happening all over the place. There are kickbacks on political decisions. There are kickbacks on policy decisions all over the place. It happens in the United States.
You are saying at least follow the basic principles of planning.
Exactly.
Tulio Bab, how are you looking? There are three issues now. One is obviously whether the intention of the government will actually translate into action. Number two, about issue of regional plan and the broader issue, why land and planning is always a problem when it comes to Goa's political class.
First of all, Prabodh Bab, let me tell you, my friend Desh congratulated the Honorable Minister and the Chief Minister for taking a bold political decision. But I must make one point here that not only he should congratulate the Chief Minister and the Honorable Minister for taking a bold, but he should also know that somebody has to take the blame and be accountable to the fact that they have agreed that the previous ODP done by their own government has failed. That the previous ODP had serious discrepancies. Will somebody be set up to inquire into these discrepancies and under what circumstances these ODPs came to be notified hurriedly by the government? Even if the PDA had whatever intentions, after all, the government has notified them. We all know that the previous town and country planning minister was in a hurry and was running the entire department very commercially. But being the government, government of the same party, somebody has to be held accountable. And one, the public at large wants to know what exactly went wrong.
Amit, what do you expect now when it comes to ODPs also? Okay, there is an intention, we need to see whether it will translate into action. But what do you expect when it comes to regional plan and now the 60 days period of scrutinizing the ODPs? What is your expectation from the government?
See, the skyline of Goa, which has changed, if you were right from drive from Chikalim, that is via airport to up to Donapal or Miramar, you see, ground plus one structure, and you see skylines changed by 9-floor structures or 8-floor structures, as we call it. Hmm. And you see that, the entire topography could have been better planned, but, this is because of haphazard planning. If you ask me, 60 days, would it be enough to put everything in place? Certainly not. I've seen planning done in areas of Para or in Arpora or in other parts of Goa, which are, small villages. But then there have been commercial spaces created next to roads, obviously with milking the cows, as you referred to it, as the PDAs have been cows which have been milked by the politicians over a period of time. It may be a very difficult task, but yes, if the intent is right, and
it's not a very difficult task. What happened was somewhere in the 90s, the definition of the zone was changed to mean a plot.
Hmm.
Before 2000 or before 1995, I think, a zone meant an area defined within a certain parameter between a set of set of roads or a certain area. That whole thing was a zone. Somewhere down the line, the definition of the word zone was changed to mean a plot.
Yeah.
So even when we say now it is a C1 zone or a settlement zone. So zone cannot mean a plot.
Zone cannot be only a piece of land which is confined to the construction.
The first thing that the government should do is change the definition of the word zone to mean what it actually is.
Mm.
And then a lot of things
are possible. Yeah, I'll take Deshbhab and Tulio, I'll come to you. Deshbhab, 2 points. Number one is regarding accountability. Tulio said that somebody needs to be accountable. You cannot just say that our government in the previous term messed it up, but now we are correcting it. Somebody needs to be held accountable. Second thing about a regional plan, now RP 2021 is effectively over, but we are probably continuing with 16B 2022 now. So how are you looking at both these aspects?
See, first of all, what I would like to tell to you is like this. See, somehow we have to trust that something is coming good out of this. Immediately running after that, somebody is accountable, then we'll have to go back in years when somebody has played some mischief here and there. At least let us go for the corrections first and then try to find out what are the things have gone wrong. Basically, I would like to come to one point, because I have been in the chair of a SCPDA Planning Development Authority as a chairman for 2 years. The basic thing what I noticed that anybody sits in that chair, people feel that only checking the files or signing the files is the only job of any PDA. Absolutely not. Because that is what I tried to show when I was there.
For coming to the final part of this discussion, don't you agree that now it's high time government starts working on the regional plan? And do you really feel when we are planning our regional plan, we should keep this demarcation between villages and cities and create these multiple bodies?
No, we should retain the character of our villages. There is no doubt about that.
No, including the distinction between the planning processes for the villages and the cities. Now, we have different bodies now. When we are preparing a regional plan, why can't we have one regional plan for Goa?
Technically and theoretically, it could be done.
Hmm.
But then there are compulsions of the government as well. So we should not really look at how the government functions. It is left to them to decide in their wisdom to take the call on how many bodies they should have. What we should be really interested in is what is the final outcome of
what are those bodies doing?
What is the final outcome of this planning? What is the output that they are giving you?
Hmm.
If whatever they give you...
Yeah, Deshbhab, I'll come to you.
No,
Deshbhab, yeah.
Basically, I would just like to add up to this. See, ultimately, ODPs are incorporated in the regional plan.
Hmm.
The whole regional plan, in that the ODPs are only the part which is being handled by that particular planning authority.
Yeah, Tulio, you wanted to make a point.
No,
yeah.
I beg to differ, Deshbhab, because the ODPs is not really an incorporation of the regional plan, because ODP is one step ahead of the regional plan. And ODPs work with a set of zoning regulations. The regional plan technically doesn't work.
That's correct. But when we have a regional plan, it is mentioned there.
Now, I'll go. to the primary discussion that we were having, because all those issues that the PDAs were not functioning properly and the member secretary, these are all administrative collapses which you all are trying to rectify now after the damage has been more than done. But I'll come to the still the basics which Pramod Bab was asking in his primary question at this. While we appreciate that the planning is a continuous process and RP 2021 will finally give way to RP 2031 as the horizon year, but let's at least understand what were the drawbacks, what were the shortcomings in this ODP, in this RP, and set the issues right. Has an elaborate study been done on what could be improved upon and what could be corrected? No. This has not been done. And that is why I had said earlier to one more channel this morning that when you set about correcting the ODPs, what is the frame that has been kept before the new committee and what are the parameters under which they have to work?
Unless we have that framework,
you are saying
this exercise may well end up being another futile exercise.
Absolutely. Okay. Now let me just add two more small points. Why I said that? Because planning is a composite exercise which has to be seamless and inclusive. It is not inclusive because this committee has got all professionals, has got the industry. But we know that in as much as we want sustainable development, that the ODP and the RP looks at conserving the natural resources of the state, which are the Khazan lands, the fields, the hills, and all the other natural reserves of the state. Where are the environmentalists or the greens in this committee? Where are the Comunidad representatives that have got all the biggest stake in the agricultural land? Where are the farmer lobbies that produce all the grain of the state? We do not have all these. Are these not part of the ODP?
Okay.
Are they to be left out?
Okay.
I ask this
fair question. Fair point. Amit, final words. What do you expect now?
I think it's time that ODPs get to planning and not just land conversions, which is what they have been restricted to so far. And they should not be treated as milking cows for making money for the politicians. And if the step is right step, hats off to the town and country planning minister. And if he achieves what he is saying he is going to achieve, it will be better for better of Goa.
Nilesh, final words.
We are very happy with the intent shown by the town and country planning minister, especially when he said that the ODPs will now concentrate, they will have a planning cell to have to concentrate on planning of a town. Not only this, he has invited all the professional associations, like for example the Indian Institute of Architects, the Indian Institute of Town Planners, the Institute of Engineers, CREDA as a professional body, have all been given representation on this committee, and I sincerely hope that he will accept our suggestions and implement them to see a better Goa.
Deshbab, final words, are you saying that let's give this a chance?
100%. That is what I would like to tell architect Leo.
And we shall meet again.
Into shoes of architect rather than going political. Trust this town planning minister, trust chief minister, trust this government. They have come together. They have come forward to take up something good for Goa.
So Deshbab,
I think they have to be given chance.
Deshbab, I am completely out of time, but
one more thing. I sincerely hope that rest of the departments, like the Urban Development Ministry, that is also with the TCG
same minister,
but things like water supply, electricity, also take this initiative make life easier for us.
Deshbab, I am wholeheartedly welcoming this exercise, but the apprehensions... The apprehensions we have expressed are only meant to convey to the government that at least now, at this point in time, look at it as an inclusive exercise rather than looking at it from just a viewpoint of development.
Yeah, I'm completely out of time, but Deshbab, one thing I can say, all four of you along with me, I think we shall meet again after 60 days, because right now what everybody is telling us is trust the intent, whether what happens with the action.
I think
after 60 days we need to relook at this, and let's have another discussion with the same panel after 60 days. Nileshbab, Tulio, Deshbab, Amit, thanks a lot for joining me on this panel. Keep watching Goa Ahead.